series. Now, this is a blinding performance in the city, May 77. First ever performance on Top of the Pops. Now from the catastrophic wardrobe department, this must be a scene from the new Austin Powers movie.
Manoeuvre as they join Radio 1 in Birmingham for a week of live music, gigs and club nights. One Live starts next Friday, BBC Radio 1.
Brutal.
And wild.
Wild Africa, one continent, so many worlds. Coming soon to BBC 2.
Britain, an island fortress moated by the sea. Over the centuries, there have been 50 invasion attempts, but you won't find all of them in the history books. So are we really an island fortress, or is Britain actually a sitting duck? For the untold stories of our national invasions, Join me, Dan Cruikshank, for a unique three-part series. Invasion starts Sunday, the 28th of October, on BBC Two.
A look back at the day's snooker action in Preston, now on BBC Two, with John Parrott and Steve Davis.
Good evening and welcome to the LG Cup. It's a seniors final on this table here tonight, but it's been quarter-finals day here at the Guildhall in Preston. Let's take a look at the draw. Stephen Lee put paid to John Higgins' chances of winning four tournaments in a row, and Mark Williams was sadly out of touch against a very, very impressive Stephen Hendry. 5-2 he ran out.
Well, that's enough of our frame. Let's get into the real deal. Peter Ebsen, the tenacious player, against the Rocket, Ronnie O'Sullivan.
Oh, hold up, before we get started.
Guess who's coming? Guess who's coming?
Playing over the park, playing football with my dad and my mum.
At school, what were your favourite subjects and what were your least favourite subjects?
Favourite subjects was PE and woodwork. Least favourite subjects were geography, English, science. Now, science was alright, because you didn't really have to do much, you just miss about. Proudest moment? Probably just taking my little daughter out of the park.
Do you have any phobias?
Needles.
What makes you angry?
When Arsenal get beat. I'd probably just like socialising with a few friends around my house in the garden, having a barbecue, weather's nice, something like that. It's a day out for me.
Have you ever felt sorry for an opponent?
Yeah.
Do you want to mention who?
No.
Okay.
When people talk to me about being, you know, good at something, or, you know, when people give me compliments, that I get quite embarrassed by that. I don't like that.
Would you be happy if nobody had ever heard of you?
Yeah, I think so. I think fame's nothing, never, ever, you know, been something that bothers me at all, you know. I'm perfectly happy to be, you know, just whatever, really.
Music's coming through. Well, the first two frames were shared, and as we join it in the third frame, Ronnie O'Sullivan is on a break of 32 and is very close to clinching it. Your commentators are Willie Thorne and John Virgo.
33.
Pots the black. Peter Ebdon will need two snookers.
Well, those two positional shots have been top draw. So Ronnie O'Sullivan only makes 40, but it should be enough now to take a 2-1 lead.
Well,
a little unlucky, but I think you'd prefer to Eight. Keep this red on the table. Snooker, free ball. And one snooker would be all that's required. 40 points behind. In actual fact, you'll... Yeah, that's right, one snooker, if you could get the free ball. Now, is it going to hit that cushion with a bit of side? Yes, good shot, Peter. Good shot. He's got to be careful here, he doesn't hit the black. Oh, good hit. That's going to make his task a little bit harder. He needs to be on a colour. I know after potting either blue or pink, he's got an easy snooker on the yellow. So he needs two snookers, so I don't suppose that's bad thinking. 33 points behind, 27 left on the table.
Seven.
And of course, certain snooker coming up. And if you can get this cue ball tight behind the blue, it'd be difficult for Ronnie to hit. Oh, that's a bit careless, Peter.
Peter Edgar,
but he
seven.
Was desperate to get that cue ball tight behind the blue.